Hello. As you know, in our modern world, things are changing fast, very fast. People are traveling all the time and need new ways to go places. Be it riding there, navigating, or flying. The vehicles we use need to adapt and accommodate these evolving requirements and be driver-friendly. Today's cars already have a number of features to help drivers. They're already autonomous to some degree. They have cruise control systems, electronic path correctors, and can park themselves, for example. Besides helping drivers, and eventually allowing them to do other things than drive on the road, all these breakthroughs will help to make vehicles more efficient, cleaner, and safer. And of course, all these technologies won't just be used in cars. They are also being developed in aerospace, for military applications, and in increasingly autonomous robots and drones. Drones are vehicles that can fly without pilots or anyone else on board. Robots are vehicles that can drive themselves over land. One example of an aerial drone we can mention is called Patroller. It can stay in the air for 20 hours, and this funny-looking contraption can climb as high as 20,000 feet to carry out surveillance missions or gather intelligence. Other autonomous vehicles, such as mini drones or this 4x4 e-rider, are designed to support land operations and protect ground units. This vehicle is distinctly stealthy and has a groundbreaking mobility system using a hybrid engine, including several electric motors. The e-rider can travel up to 190 miles at up to 45 miles an hour. It can be driven the usual way or be used as a robot, for example, to follow troops from a distance. And of course, it can also follow a predefined itinerary all by itself and negotiate unexpected obstacles. These self-flying drones and self-driving robots can be partially or fully autonomous. They use several embedded sensors to sense their surroundings intelligently. These sensors are much sharper than the human eye, so vehicles can see things that people would miss. They can model and map out their surroundings using artificial intelligence and dodge any threats. These vehicles use optronics, meaning a combination of cameras, laser beams, and image processing capabilities, along with inertial navigation to plot out their own routes. Some of these vehicles can see through thick fog, or even at night using infrared vision. And they can operate in weather conditions which aren't the best. At this point, engineers are taking a new look at the vehicle's entire architecture. For example, vehicles will have wheels that move and drive independently, meaning that tomorrow's autonomous vehicles will be able to do things that are impossible today. There, you know everything, or nearly everything. Before we leave you, note that autonomous vehicles are here to stay and that the 21st century will no doubt see drivers and pilots freed from all their constraints.